be on my screen this morning again. May the name of the Lord be praised and glorified. That his name would be made holy and would be sanctified. Our Father in heaven, may your name be kept holy for this precious. In the name of the whole church, I would like to say once again, even though those important my remarks are not here, we deeply appreciate the parents teaching the children verses from the Bible. Unbelievable and important, and in times of trial, and in hard times of life, so many times the Holy Spirit would remind us of the verses that we have learned in our houses, when we are with friends. Did you make, or did you understand, or did you hear something interesting in what the teacher said here and put it in the left of your mind? Because I heard something that I never heard in my life, and nothing can stick with me for a long time. Remember the child that prayed our Father? Remember what he said? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be my name. I think we should pray this prayer every day, because our God is holy. May his name be sanctified, but also may our names be made holy, our life and our living for God. The Bible itself says, be holy for I am holy. And we have the Lord's Supper with us. There's some food in there, something to drink. And it's good to eat. But after the prayer, we know, because things are sanctified, made holy by prayer, supplication, dedication. This, the Lord's Supper, will be changed in the emblems, and the Lord's Supper will be made holy. And it's good to think that our God is holy, we are to be holy, and we serve a holy. We're here for the glory of God. The Lord that's good. Well, thank you for your interesting years, so I'm going to come with you with something that I feel was given to me, and there was connections of the Lord's Supper. The Lord's Supper is really connected to things in the Bible, and we better learn to study and ask the Lord to teach us. The verse that we'd like to have with us in the minutes to come is 1 Corinthians 11:26. I'm trying to look at the Lord's Supper through this idea of the connection. What do we say? For every time we eat this bread or drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until he comes again. Let's look at the Lord's Supper in this verse. And look at the connection of the Lord's Supper, the power of the connection. that we find in the Bible. And the first one that we picked was in the same text, 1 Corinthians 11:27 to 32. So, anyone who eats this bread or drinks this cup of the Lord unworthily is guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of Christ. For serving the Lord's Supper, we said every upgrade and we just made holy. Oh, is the Lord's Supper connected to this verse? What is the next one to us? We go to the, what is it? It was the 1 Corinthians 11, 47 to 32. Just that to 32. When we are judged by the Lord, we are being self-disciplined so that we will not be condemned along with the world. We look back at each other to discipline. There is the possibility that we approach the Lord's Supper unworthily. And then the Lord's Supper is connected to the call of punishment, especially in our religion. When we are judged by the Lord, we are punished by the Lord, as we are doing. So we will have to condemn at the same time we are learning. So the text presents the Lord's Supper beautifully. In Proverbs 53, do not approach the Lord's Supper without knowing. But there's some consequences in doing it. There is reproach, in Romanian, punishment. There is some discipline that the Lord is going to do with us. This judgment is here. The universe says, being disciplined. This is not the sense that the Lord is going to say death to us. But it's just the parents whose son makes a mistake. And this is the best for this son. But unless the son is stopped, and unless the son is disciplined, what other words would you use? Disciplined? With pleasure, correction. And this is serious business. You know why? Because we have fallen above this and died. So we are here, these are qualities possible, just like in the church. But as the Americans say, the Lord's Supper is not a business. I don't want to push the Easter to the point where we just pray and say, oh, this is holy, I'm not going to do anything, I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to stay home when the Lord's Supper is served, but I need to fast and begin to suffer to get closer to the Lord. I'm not taking the risk here. There is a Holy God. There is a Holy Church. And there is a Holy Supper. And it's all together. Don't pretend that you are coming out. God knows it better. He also knows if none of us is worthy really what it is we take to look at. And then what is going on? What are we to do? We have to come to the Father through the Lord Jesus Christ, who is worthy. Is that like the lawyer who goes to the judge and you go in there to be condemned, sentenced? You, for the thing you have done, you have to pay $1,000. But the lawyer who defends himself, Your Honor, I understand everything. My client is guilty. But he has to pay for the wrong that he was done. He is $1,000. And then, John is satisfied just as his son is said, go in peace. Christ has done that for us and by it. So it is in the hour of time to praise the Lord, to make us talk to the Lord Jesus. And remember that one of the things connected to the Lord's Supper is brotherly relationship and there is the discipline which comes with it. The requirement is that we are holy, that we will be a holy vessel. God understands our imperfections, but God is still listening to the heaven. Our prayers when they go to Him, to the Lord Jesus Christ. Once again, God sees the wound in the heart. And there's a voice. He doesn't have a relationship. Amen. That a spike will put up. I don't like the translation with a nail. A nail is something that is very small and does not fall. The description of a spike that is used as a railway. One by one, we will all feel the rock on your face. No, in the sense of spice on it, something at least gives it a goal to hold the way. That's the kind of spice that we want to use to scare everything in being wrong. Because it's not the way. Blessed be our Lord Jesus Christ. And He maybe the things that are between us and the Lord when we go wrong, but we do. This is what I request to you, connectors. Gather connectors. I'm thinking with Matthew 26 and 29, is that the what you're heading for? Mark my words. I will not drink wine until the day I drink with you, with you in my Father's kingdom. This is an interesting connection. It's not happening here. It is not happening and it's not going to happen. This is it, today. But what I'm telling you is that the Lord, I will not drink wine with you until the day I drink it. When with you, drink with you, with you in my Father's kingdom. What are we to you? What are you talking about? Drinking wine? And what am I going to do? I'm going to eat. And I'm not going to drink until I get into the kingdom of God. Is that what it says? Or is this a connection of the today's Lord? And that connection refers to what kind of happens in heaven. There's another version there, is it Luke 22:15? Jesus said, I have been very eager to eat this Passover meal with you before my suffering. And if you read, again, he refers to this idea of the Lord's Supper on earth being connected to faith in the kingdom of God. It's like a thing. One end is the Lord's Supper, and the other end is the eternity of Christ, the church, and all the saints and all the angels. Eating and drinking in the presence of the Father. In a few words, this connection tells us that the Lord Jesus Christ lives with eternity in this temporary life. I want to tell you of other things that decades have gone by in my life. Just like yesterday. I don't remember anything. And I cannot say about myself that I live so much concentrating on what is to come, on what is eternal. It doesn't matter if we are Messiah. And you live close to 1,000, I'm not really close to 1,000 and 90. This life on earth has a ending. That's why, just like the Lord Jesus in this temporary life, we are to live with eternity in mind. With eternity in mind, I pray. With eternity in mind, I sing. With eternity in mind, I give. And with eternity in mind, and by the word in English, you almost do. What is that? I rebuke my wife, my children, my friends, my enemies, with eternity in mind. I rebuke it. I might be right, but how many times was I wrong with my life? Christ lives with eternity in mind. Can we give with eternity in mind? Or we always give counting how much money is in the wallet. Put me to death, says the Lord. Put me to death. Give us, not second. Lord, give me $1,000,000, so 905,099, I'm going to give it back to you. You'll never get $1,000,000. You'll never get $1,000,000. It doesn't make any sense. Bless me first and then I will. God wants to see that we are faithful in everything that we do. And I give not because I'm thinking of a reward, but because I want to be part of the kingdom of God, of the miracles of God, of the things that the unbelievers would see and understand. So there is, yes, not only this short life lived on earth, but there's eternity coming, and that eternity is coming too. One side is happiness and bliss forever and ever, and the other side is hell and torture and pain and tears forever. And forever means there's no end. I don't understand. My mind, I'm too small. I'm just like a little mouse thinking of Paul Eiffel in Paris. I'm a little mouse looking at the tower. Isn't this big? But I am also strong. Beloved, eternity counts. Eternity is important, and all the things that are connected to eternity. And today we are talking about the fact that this Lord's Supper that we have with us is connected to the eternity. There will eat and there will drink. I don't understand how. I'm not even talking. Don't lose time with understanding. Faith stands forever. How can it be? How can it be? Especially, you're the mathematician, 2 plus 2 is 4, blah, 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 blah. One guy said this, I can prove to you that 8 times 8 is not 64. And I said, I don't believe you. I said, he used some tricks in mathematics. And he saw that 8 times 8 is not 64. How can it be? That's why we don't need to know everything. We don't need to understand everything what the Bible says. Our things that we accept and do by faith in God. And I invest in the kingdom because I know that God can use my little money to save a soul. Or the little that I have, I don't know. Can't do it because He's omnipotent and He can do it all. Oh Lord. Let's come to the connection that we wanted to talk about, and that connection is in 1 Corinthians 11 and 26, where it comes when it talks about the Lord Jesus, and the connection is the Lord suffers His soul, the Lord is present, and the supper is connected to the return of the Lord Jesus. Maranatha, beloved, the Lord is coming. I don't know. I would like to have another day or another week or another year or another opportunity to go on the mission field, etc. If we go to John 14 and 3, this will be proof biblical that our Lord's Supper, that the supper that we have in here is connected to what's going to happen. When everything is ready, I will come and get you so that you will always be with me where I am. The Trinity is connected to the return of the Lord Jesus. And now the Father starts. Because some of us have gone the wrong way. Is the Lord Jesus coming? Do you believe it? Even if we don't believe it, the Lord is going to come anyway. It's not up to me. Nothing is up to me. Everything is up to Him. My breath, my blood pressure. He tells me how to walk and move and but the doctor is giving some pills. But God is in control over all. So, we understand that He will come again, as it says on Acts 1 and 11. Jesus Himself says, I shall come again. That is the testimony of the angel that comes. And what does it say? Acts 1 and 11. Men of Galilee, they said, why are you standing here staring into the heaven? Jesus has been taken from you into heaven, but someday He will return from heaven in the same way you saw Him go. I was there. I was right on top of the mountain. 1987. Now it's more difficult than something it is. But as we were on top of the mountain, they put a stone in there, and I think it's just a stone. But they said, come, give me $2. And I let you stand on the stone. Jesus stood when He took off. And I said, keep your life, I'll keep my money. feel right, I'll give my money. Because nowhere there's proof that they're in the stone or that he sat on the stone before he took off. They were looking at talking and he left. And he was having the same manner. Beloved, this idea of the Lord Jesus Christ returning is so complicated and we might not have time to go into it today. Why? Because the Lord is coming. It's a little stronger in English than Romanian. Don't put Venus already, he is coming. In English, it emphasizes this return. It's a stronger word emphasizing the returning. I believe it's coming. When we were in love and we went into the whatever outside on the grass in the evening and we looked at the stars, it was so beautiful. And we knew this from up there. One day the Lord will come. We are not eternal. My years have gone like a dream. I don't know how much is left, but for sure the Lord Jesus is coming. What did the Lord Jesus declare in Matthew 24:35-36? Heaven and earth will disappear, but my word will never disappear. However, no one knows the day or the hour when these things will happen. Not even the angels in heaven or Son himself. Only the Father knows. How could it be possible? Isn't the Lord Jesus God? You say yes, but then why doesn't he know when he's coming back? It's in the Bible. And he's thinking to government to talk to you today. Don't even bother. They haven't done it in 2,000 years. He will not do it today. Because the Word of God is true. Regardless of what we think. People try to solve the problem and they read the Bible, turned the pages to Daniel. Of course, Revelation. And they said 200 plus 250 years is 450 years plus 600 years is 1,050 years. So, this kind of comes into our generation. So he is coming. And they started and preached it, and they got adherents and people following this teaching. So they sold in many places everything they had, and they went in white dresses up the mountain to help to wait because the Lord Jesus was coming. This man. They could not sure they thought or they might, but they can. And every spy was useless, Whatever they had was gone. Now they had the white clothes and became liars. Because they were preaching that the Lord Jesus is coming. You are my family. And I tell you, one of our people. We were talking. We were talking exactly about this. And he said, I know why. Even the Lord Jesus, even the Son doesn't know when he's coming for the rapture, of course, right? We know what we're talking about. We're not far from the subject. I tell you why. Because God the Father knew. Jesus would love the church. His brother would love her so much that without the Father knowing, he would love it to the ground. said, I have never heard of heresy bigger than that. As far as I'm concerned, brother, you are a liar, and I'm going to pray for you. But to say a man that you would so much love, just so much love the first people, that he could not hold this love, and the power of his Christ, and the power that he can get by his Christ. So, then, brother and brother, I hope that you repented and the Lord forgave him. But let us be very careful that the Lord may come today. The Lord may come today. If he comes today, the big question is, am I ready? The Lord gave an advice in Matthew 24, 42, and 44. Can we look at this advice that he gave us? Not only that he told the people that he is going to come back, that we saw the other two connections, that there's a peace in heaven connected. Also, there's a punishment connected to the Lord's Supper for those who take it unworthily. But this Matthew 24, 42, is from the Lord Jesus himself. So you too must keep watch, for you don't know what day your Lord is coming. And 44, please. Understand this. You should go to the 44. If a home memory is graphic, also, you also must be ready. This is the advice of the Lord Jesus to us today, having the Lord's Supper here. You also must be ready all the time, for the Son of Man will come when the least expect it. Now I know, now you know where the Lord is coming. You know, it says here, the Lord is coming when least expecting. Oh, I want another house, I want another car, I want another million, I want another travel, I want another wife. This is no good. I want to be a doctor, I want to fly in the face. And you never think that was a day when you entered the waters of baptism. And you were asked, for how long of a time do you or accept or take this baptism? And he said, until I die. That means from now until I die. Not when I'm poor or rich. Not when I'm sick or tired or healthy. The word says that the Son of Man, the Lord Jesus Christ, will come when least expected. When least expected. Is there a possibility that we kind of lose? Yeah, the Lord is coming, but I want to grasp my soul back. I want to get this coming, and he has so much money. And then the Lord Jesus can come. Yes, I love you. You reckon? Of course, to the good for crying to your neighbor. And for them, love is not important. Money is important. But again, this does not talk about people who don't know the Lord. It talks about the church. Because Israel really is the people of God. Yes, the Lord is coming. God saves anyone who believes. You can be a Gentile, or you can be a Jew. God forgives anyone who repents. Because of time is done, and I'd like to just go over this one thing I need to say.
in the Bible, please remember, in the Bible, Jews and Gentiles are two separate entities. There are two kinds of people. Let's read in Luke 21 and 24. I'm talking about the fact that there is a connection between the Lord's Supper that we're taking today and a number of people, which are the Gentiles. When this number is fulfilled, the grace, the favor of God, will return to Israel. And at least for me, when this number is fulfilled, I believe that this is a time when the Lord Jesus is coming to take the bride away. Could that number be fulfilled today? Maybe. Could the number be fulfilled next week? I don't know. But look in the Bible, because I'm sorry, we're rushing to this most important thing. The Lord Jesus talks about the time for Gentiles, meaning for us, not for the Jews. Let's read Luke 21:24. Do we have it there? What does it say? Talk about the Jews, okay? They will be killed by the sword or sent away as captives as the nation to all the nations of the world. And Jerusalem will be trampled down by the Gentiles, meaning us, not the Jews. Until the period, this is why I checked this first. Please, this is so important. Until the period of the Gentiles comes to an end. One of the churches in Revelation, remember, we were talking when the chair was here. And he said, the Lord Jesus might be here judging us. One of those churches said to a lady, I think the lady Jesus said, I have given her time. I have granted her, I the Lord, granted her this sinner was supposed to die. Really, I granted her time to repent. But she would not. How the weather in Italian, that's what we call it. Padura, think of it. I do my way. But Gentiles have a period, meaning an interval of time, from here to here. I would say, from the coming of the Lord Jesus, he did a sacrifice, he died for us from that time until the return. Because after the return of the Lord to take us away, the natural time, the grace of God, the new God, will go and do real business with the world. We are His church, but in them is His people. So let's not mingle them and get in trouble again. So, more than just Romans 11:25, please pay attention to this. It's so important. Romans 11:25. I want you to understand my dignity. You belka voice of incerte staina casa. Misteru, interessante. Il termine noi che il nome di Cristo sia, di credere lì a nome di Cristo, evidentemente la stessa. I want you to understand his mystery, this mystery, dear brothers and sisters, so that you will not feel proud about yourself. Some of the people of Israel have hard Christ. But this will last only until he is alive. Will last until the full number of Gentiles come to Christ. What is the full number? I don't know. Who counts the full number? God. And the Christians, God has counted. Has counted. Today, he repented. Of one, plus one. Today, he repented. Plus another one. The count of God goes. Tomorrow, he will repent. Another one. So the count of God. It seems like at the Christmas day, I think that at the end of the year, when they count the signs and days and whatever, the hours and meetings, get back and boom! Happy New Year! Because at zero, they're supposed to celebrate the New Year. So there's a number there. Nobody can do anything about it except that we can repent and wait for the Lord Jesus. And stay with the Holy Spirit. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. Is the number going to be today at 12:30? I wish. What would I do? I think I would not go home. I'll stay here, cry, and wait for the Lord for his coming at 12:30. What about the night of the moment? But he would not give us a date because he wants to always be his. It's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and Monday. We do not know his return and when, but we know that there's a time for Gentiles for us to fulfill that number. And it makes sense that at that moment, the trumpet to sound. And for the King of all kings to come and take us away, and we will respond gladly, even though, come, Lord Jesus, even though, what do you mean, even though? Even if I'm tired, even if I'm sick, even if I fell in sin and I'm coming back crawling to the Lord. Even though I'm old or young or beautiful or sick or healthy, even so, Lord, oh, you want $1 million out of me. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. And if I'm nothing, if I lose my beloved, particularly from family, that is my parents, that is my wife, my husband, I'm hurting, even in that time of trial and tribulation, I will say, even so, yes, but I'm hurting, yes, but someone died, yes, but this and that and that, but even so, come, Lord Jesus. The closing is very simple. There's nothing. There's no word. All the numbers of the world cycle is connected with the return of the Lord and our being taken away. But this will last only until the full number of Gentiles comes to Christ. Let us gladly serve the Lord. And always thank God for another moment. When it can depend, when the door is open, and we can belong and remain of Christ. Remain as a children, as a family that is waiting for the Lord. May God richly help every one of us as we are returning, as the Lord is returning, and we do celebrate the Lord.
Father.